The Jacob Zuma Foundation says Justice Raymond Zondo's comments are an attack on the former president. The foundation has been responding to the State Capture Commission's demand that Zuma appear in November. It says Zondo is obsessed with Jacob Zuma. Let's discuss this with legal expert attorney Ntabi Singh Dubazana. And Ntabi Singh, good morning. Thanks so much for your time. Happy Heritage Day to you this morning as well. So we see the statement released by the Jacob Zuma Foundation, and we just have to wonder, first things first, before we get to the actual content, this is a foundation. It's not coming from the legal team. It's not coming from you know, any sort of official source in that way. So how much weight does a statement like this actually carry? And if I have to be blunt about it, who's going to care what the foundation has to say about this issue?
Legally speaking, I don't think anybody would really care what's happening when it comes from a foundation, because like you just mentioned, it's not a legal document. It's not the attorneys of Mr. Jacob Zuma who are saying that you have done 1, 2, 3, 4, and as a result, we are intending to retaliate, or rather to go to courts to take you to task for what you have done so far. However, the issues raised in this document are very interesting, even though they're not put legally. It's just, it's, to me, sounds like a rant more than anything else when I read the statement thoroughly. They are saying you should have done this instead of doing that. You did not pick on Praveen Gordhan when he didn't even file an affidavit. That statement, for example, is legitimate. It makes sense. Why are you holding me to task as Jacob Zuma when you haven't done the same blanket approach to every witness who was supposed to testify in the commission? But be that as it may, it is a concern that is being raised. It should be one that should be addressed, seeing that the platform that Zondo put raised this issue at, which is the media space. So now they had to retaliate also, or rather they chose to retaliate in the media space as well.
Well, to that point where you say, yes, there seems to be some legitimate concern. There are some points raised. They also talk about, in the statement, about when this was actually communicated to the president's attorneys. They say this was communicated on Friday, the 18th of September. We heard from Deputy Chief Justice Zondo earlier this week. Now, do they have a point there that you haven't given us enough time to respond, and then you do this via the media? Is there something to that?
Yes, I definitely agree. Let's say for argument's sake, it was sent at 8 o'clock in the morning. It was received 8:30 by Jacob Zuma's legal team. That is from Friday until Monday. It's not even court hours or court dates. So it's not 48 hours of notification at minimum. You know what I mean? So because Saturday and Sunday is not a time whereby it is considered part of the court dates and the court hours. So it is a legitimate concern. I'm not sure what the time scope is that is put with the commission regarding when you should respond when you are asked to appear in court, what times, et cetera, et cetera. But I do believe that 48 hours would have been at least a minimum. So it's only been a few hours between Friday and then Monday when the interview or other media hosting or briefing was done by Dr. Zondo. So I feel like they were not given enough time in order for them to respond to whatever queries and questions and demands, but they should be present at the commission. If there's things that need to be filed beforehand, if there's questions they need to clarify before they appear, they were not given enough time.
So just given, though, the former president's tactics, and I think, you know, we've all been quite open about that in trying to avoid this commission, or what's being seen as him trying to avoid this commission and having to come to answer to it and, you know, basically using everything possible not to appear, was in a way, or to some extent, the Deputy Chief Justice, maybe, you know, we all could see that he was quite fed up. He seemed like he'd had enough of this, with the repeated attempts by the former president not to be there, that maybe in a way this was his way of putting his foot down. But was it necessarily wrong, or not the best way to conduct things?
Well, let's be honest. The commission is not a court of law. It's literally just that. It's a commission. So whether him being fed up or not, to me, is irrelevant. Because if it was a court of law, there's processes to be followed. This commission, yes, it has processes to be followed. But anything coming out of this commission is not legally binding to anyone. Do you get what I'm saying? So him being that upset and saying he is now... because of the antics of Ntate Zuma and what he's doing, as a result, he's now fed up and et cetera, et cetera. He hasn't disproven that Ntate Zuma was sick. He hasn't because he once said that he wants to meet the doctor of Ntate Zuma prior so that he can prove that he was sick. That to me is irrelevant. If there's proof that he was sick and there's a doctor's note and whatever, if you feel the doctor must come and testify, then you have to give reason why the doctor must come to a commission of inquiry to come and testify. In a court of law, yes. If the doctor's note is not accepted by the court, they will request that the doctor come and testify in court and say that, yes, indeed, on this day that Zuma was admitted, we did 1, 2, 3, 4. Here is his chart, of course, with the permission of the client or the patient, because remember, you can't breach the patient-doctor confidentiality situation. So this commission is only here to inform the public of what has been happening. There's nothing legally binding that's going to come out of this situation. So him being as upset as he is, and also threatening that he's going to issue summons, I read, that how are you going to lay basis to issue summons? Based on what? Because the commission's rules don't say that if you fail to appear, the commission, the head of the commission can thus issue a summons. It says rules can be changed as they go, but they still have to be approved. So I feel like, because unfortunately Mr. Zuma has been in the public eye for so long regarding this thing, the attention on him is taking away from what's trying to be accomplished by the commission.
And Tabi Singh, just all of that being said and done, if the former president's legal team is going to use some of this now to make a case, can it be used as the basis to avoid this commission even further, or even to discredit it and discredit the Deputy Chief Justice in this process?
100%. Hell, I think I would probably try and do a civil case against Mr. Zondo in person for what he has said in the media against me, because he has not brought forth in the media proof that I did not comply with his request to appear in the commission based on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is already a defamation of character. You're saying that I'm a bad person, I don't follow the law and whatnot. You could even, if possible, throw in a criminal case there for criminal injury, which is basically the criminal version of what is this? The reputation thing I just said.
Defamation,
there we go, the defamation of character. So the legal team definitely does have a leg to stand on. Question is, will they do it, or will they let it slide and just continue with going into the commission itself?
Seriously doubt they will let it slide, but the days will tell. Thanks very much, Attorney Tabi Singh Dubazana there.